Yeehaw. Where's your lowly?
Sure, yeah. We wrote a book here. You know, it's kind of about my life and my journey through baseball that led me to Taiwan and my experience here the past 9 years in Taiwan and just that journey through baseball. I hope you all enjoy it. Surprised? You know, just something I never really thought about, and it took me a couple days to kind of digest it and make a decision whether to move forward with writing the book or not.
当初接到跟罗莉一起完成这本书的时候，其实第一件事情就是先去回想罗莉的生涯一些他的时刻，然后第一个部分当然要先把它分成不同的章节嘛，所以就稍微要把他的这个生涯稍微去把它做一些分段的动作，然后就把它打出来，然后用文字的方式打出来，然后再把这样子的东西透过我们，因为我们有一个联络群组嘛，然后就可能把这个章节呢稍微有传给罗莉，让罗莉也去确认一下。那他确认没有问题之后，我们就是照着这个章节我们去做我们的方案的工作。那所以每一个章节的这个大纲定出来之后，其实在每一次访谈前的到2到3天吧，我也会透过这个工作群组的方式，把该章节我想要问的题目先列出来。然后跟罗莉约定的时间到之后，我就是照着这个我的原本设定的访纲的题目去让罗莉去把她的故事讲出来。
No, you know, I thought the process went really smooth. Keith, you know, did a great job making that process of telling the story very, very easy. So Keith would ask questions, and you know, I would tell stories, and I thought the whole process was.Very smooth and very comfortable.
因为我跟罗莉之前共事的期间，花了很多时间在球场上，跟花在重量室，所以其实我们在彼此的沟通上面本来就有一定的默契，跟一定我们会共同用的语言。所以说，在写书的时候，我觉得那个部分也帮助到很大，因为我们有很多我们彼此都很熟识的语言的用法。所以说，我觉得在这样的过程中，也让整个过程是更简单的。
I mean, I guess honestly, I couldn't. So, you know, I trusted Keith and, you know, Bruce, Xiaoher, that, you know, they had all the information, you know, it was all recorded and that it was put together the right way. So, you know, this is a group of guys that, you know, I trust in and, you know, believe that they're going to put the book together in the best way possible.
这个部分出版商跟我们这边其实有做过一些初步的讨论，之后应该会想办法把它用英文的方式呈现。那不过这个部分就比较是属于做出来让它有一个纪念的这种感觉。至少我觉得对啊，毕竟是一本自己的故事，却自己却没有办法去理解，这个也是怪怪的。所以这个部分我们的确是有一些计划了。
That's a good question. I think I told a pretty good story already. If there does come a point where, you know, I feel there's a need to tell more stories, I think I hit them all though. So I don't think there really ever will be more to the story.
印象深刻的绝对是我一直有提到，就是2016年打冠军的那一次，因为我们毕竟在那一年其实真的。那个冠军真的得来不易，然后我觉得有参与到那次冠军的所有人，其实都在那个过程中，我觉得都有很大的收获。所以说，能够透过跟罗莉访谈的过程中，再去重新的回两个人再重新去回忆那一段很好的时光，我觉得是印象最深刻的。
It was amazing. You know, the fans have treated me so well for so long, and coming back after I retired, I guess it's been like 6-7 months, and the reception that they gave me.The love that I could feel from them was truly special and still is special. So, something that I appreciate and certainly don't take for granted. just to enjoy it, you know, because I knew I was going to go out and pitch, and that would be truly my last time pitching in a game in front of fans, you know, for Fubon. So, it was more about just enjoying the moment.That brief moment, you know, facing one batter, getting to warm up in the bullpen, going out there, you know, having my name announced one more time. So I was just trying to enjoy it, embrace it, because, you know, that was going to be the last time. So I just was trying to take those mental notes and really, really remember the moment. The plan is to continue my role as the foreign player scout for FUBON. I've been coaching my son at home, coaching his little league team, so that's all the plans I have in baseball.
这次很高兴有这个机会可以跟罗莉一起完成这个我觉得非常有意义的一件事情。那这本书我觉得就像罗莉自己讲的，写了很多他的故事。那我觉得更重要的是，我觉得呈现了很多他的情感的部分，包括他对家人的情感，他对球迷的情感，他对球团、对富邦的这些感激之情。我觉得可以去深深的去体会到这个部分，因为我们很多时候看到，不要说是外籍选手，看到本土选手，也都只是看到球场上的表现。可我觉得这本书里面很真实的把罗莉的一些喜怒哀乐跟他的一些他的这种感情的部分呈现出来，我觉得是一个非常值得一读的一本书。